Hello friends, welcome to Plant Science Forum. Today's topic of discussion is plant morphological characters. Understanding of morphological characters of various plant organs is a key tool for taxonomic identification and nomenclature of plant concern. Please note that the various characters covered in this talk are not complete and sufficient for identification, but it is just a preliminary guide for beginners of morphological studies. Morphological characters can be divided into two types: vegetative characters of root, stem and leaves, and floral characters where we include bract, pedicel, sepal, petal, androecium and gynoecium. So these are broadly two categories for the morphological studies. The study of plant morphological characters always begins with the plant habit. It is the general appearance, growth form, or architecture of the plant. These are the various plant habits. First one, rosette formation, forming. It is a non-wood and non-climbing. It shows the whorl of leaves at the base of stem. Second is climbing, twining or struggling. In this type, the plant may be woody, herbaceous, but stem are not self-supporting, so needs some sort of anchorage. Third one is the prostrate or decumbent. In this type, plant is woody, spread flat along the ground with its tip turning upwards. Next habit is the erect or ascending shrub. They are upright, having multiple stem and smaller than trees. And the next plant habit is the tree. So these are some of the plant habits which we can generally observe in nature. Now, first plant organ to be studied is root. It is normally underground part that develops from the radical of the germinating seed. Now, there are two types of root system, true and false type. Now, just to understand the true root system, look at the seed germination process. Germinating seeds forms two appendages, one is plumule and other is the radical. Plumule gives shoot and radical gives root. The true root system is only those which is formed from the radical of germinating seed. Now, this radical gives rise to a taproot system. Any other type of roots which does not emerge from the radical is a false root, such as adventitious roots. So here this is the example of taproot, you can see, and these are the examples of adventitious type of root system. The next plant organ to be studied is stem. It is the above ground part that develops from the plumule of the germinating seed. Now, stem is categorized in some different types. First is the reduced. This is the cross section of onion, reduced type of stem. Here it can be seen. Now look, this yellow portion. This yellow portion, it represents the reduced type of stem in onion, and these are the foliage leaves. Now another type is the culm type of stem, which can be seen in bamboo. Another type is caudex or columnar. In this type, stem throughout its length do not bear any leaf appendages. Only a crown of leaves is present at the apex or tip of the stem. Next is the twining type. In this, a stem is weak and it's encircle or twine around the available support for anchorage. Next is the tendril type. Again, stem is weak. Here it produces specialized appendages called tendrils for encouragement to the available support. Next is the root climber. Here, stem produces roots at nodal position for encouraging to the support. If you look at here, now these are the root climbers, and apparently you can see a different types of roots which are arising at the nodal portion of the stem for encouraging to the substratum. Now next is the procumbent types. In procumbent types, stem just after emerging from the ground starts spreading. You can see here, this is the procumbent type. Here in the center, stem just after emerging from the ground, it starts spreading on the surface. Now next, here as green you can see, it is the decumbent type. After emerging from the ground, stem grows erect to some extent and then it starts spreading. Next is the stolon. It is the connection or means of propagation for establishing new plants at some frequent distance, and the established daughter plant is called as runner. So these are the different types of stems. Next is the leaves. It is the green, flat, thin, expanded lateral appendages of stem which is born at the node. While studying leaf, these are some of the important characters to be noted. As you can see here, apex, margin, veins, midrib, base of leaf, petiole and the stipule. These are the important characters needs to be studied. Now, there are certain kinds of types of leaves. If the leaf is single and directly borne on the stem, then it is called simple leaf. If the lamina of leaf is dissected and forms a leaflet, then it is called pinnately compound leaf. And if the lamina of leaf is dissected to give a palm-like appearance, then it is called palmately compound leaves. Now there are certain types of leaf venation: reticulate unicostate, reticulate multicostate. Here in the image, you can see a parallel venation, pinnate venation, or palmate venation. These are etc. Now there are various type of leaf shape such as linear, obovate, ovate, pinnately lobed, palmately lobed, reniform, lanceolate, sagittate. All these type of shape depends upon the size of leaf at the base and the apex, how it is forming that particular shape. Again, leaf margins also shows the different types. If margin is continuous, then it is entire, and if it forms notches in the margin, then a few different types according to the margins are crenate, dentate, serrate and lobed. Now this is next, this is very important as far as leaf morphological characters is concerned. That is arrangement of leaf on stem. It is called as phyllotaxy. Now few important types are alternate, opposite and whorl. There are again subtypes to this, but we are looking it very brief. Next utmost important plant organ to be studied is flower. It is the condensed modified shoot which is meant for sexual reproduction. The characters of the flower to be studied are stalk of the flower, that is pedicel, receptacles, sepals, petals, sepals in group called as calyx, petals in group called as corolla, then androecium, gynoecium. Androecium also shows different characters such as lobe types, filament, their fixation. Gynoecium also has many different characters. Now, this is the general representation of floral diagram. It shows how different floral whorls are arranged among themselves. One of the important characters of flower is symmetry. If flower is divided into two equal halves by any plane passing through its center, then it is called as actinomorphic. Now, next image. If the flower is divided into two equal halves by only one plane, then it is called as zygomorphic. And if flower cannot be divided into equal halves by any plane, then it is called as asymmetrical type of flower. Next important character is the position of ovary. If all the floral whorls arises from the base of the ovary, then it is called as hypogynous flower. If all the floral whorls arises from upper side of the ovary, then it is called as epigynous flower. And if floral whorls are not arising either from base or apex of the ovary but from the intermediate position, then it is called as perigynous flower. Now, next character of flower is aestivation. Aestivation is studied in calyx and corolla. If all the individual members of whorls lying side by side without overlapping, then it is called valvate type of aestivation. If all the members of whorl overlap each other from one side, then it is called a twisted type of aestivation. If one of the member is completely inside and one is completely outside, then it is called as imbricate type of aestivation. Let's understand this. Now, valvate, all their side lying side by side in twisted, one side is out and one side is inner. That means all are overlapping, that's why they are twisted. In imbricate, one member is completely outside whereas one member is completely inside and other three, they are overlapping. That's why it is called as imbricate. Now come to quinquenchial. In the quinquenchial, two members are completely outside and two members are completely inside and one member is overlapping. Now look here, this and this, these are completely outside while this member and this, it is completely inside whereas this one is overlapping. So this is called as quinquenchial. Now this vexillary, it is a special type of imbricate aestivation formed due to variable shape of corolla. Now next important character is the arrangement of ovule on placenta inside the ovary, which is called as placentation. Now first is marginal type, that is ovule presents on margin of the ovary. Other is the exile placentation, that is ovules present on the central axis of the ovary. Next is free central, ovules arrange freely in the ovary on a axis. Another is two different kinds of parietal, ovules present on the peripheral walls of the ovary locules. And last one is a blesal type of placentation where ovules is present at the base of ovary. Now another important character is fixation of anther lobes to the filament. Here filament and anther lobe, they are fixed at the point of base of lobes, so it is basifixed. In the next adenate, filament runs throughout the length of antherlobe. It is called as adenate. In another type, filament is attached to the dorsal side of the antherlobe. It is called as dorsifixed. In the versatile, filament is attached to the antherlobe by a single point, because of which antherlobes can turn around or it can rotate in 360 degrees. So it is a versatile. Next is the divergent, where a diathecous anther is spread out by a branches of filament. Along with this, some important terms related to the androecium is the intrours, extrours, inserted and exserted. Now let's look at one by one. Now intrours. Intrours means the anthers, they are facing towards the gynoecium. As you can see here, this yellow part, they are the anthers, and this is the, this green part is gynoecium. Now these androecium, they are facing towards the gynoecium, that's why they are intrours. And also these anthers, they are inside the corolla tube, they are not protruding outside the corolla tubes. As they are inside, they are called as inserted types. Now look at this image. Here the anthers, they are facing away from the gynoecium, so they are extrours. And also these anther stamens, they are outside the corolla tube, so they are exserted. So these are four important terms related to the androecium: intrours, extrours in relation to the position of ovary, and inserted and exserted in relation to the length of filament. Now these are the important notations and symbols for writing a floral diagram or floral formula. Sorry, not diagram, it is the formula. Now here you can see a various floral morphological characters, their symbols and their notation. Along with the studying morphological characters, it is also important to know the distribution of plant species. So these are the different climatic zones of the planet Earth. That is tropical zone, shown by red in the circle here, tropical, subtropical, and upside to it is temperate zone, and terminal is the polar zone. Here you can see with respect to the map. Here this is India. Most of the part of India is tropical and subtropical zone, whereas some part of Jammu Kashmir is a temperate zone. Now while studying plant science, you will encounter these two terms more frequently and sometimes interchangingly. Taxonomy, it involves the classification and naming of organisms, whereas systematic involves the determination of evolutionary relationship among the organisms. This is all in a very brief about the various plant morphological characters and some key terms and facts about the taxonomy and systematics. If you like the video, please subscribe the channel. Thank you.